a professional football team and his players leaving that team, claiming he was bullied, is bringing more attention to the issue.
KOAT Action 7 News reporter Todd Kurtz has more on the staggering numbers of men and women being bullied at work.
When you hear the term bully, most people picture the playground. But more and more studies show bullying is popping up in the workplace with damaging effects.
That's the ultimate thing with bullying. It causes people's harm.
Workplace bullying is defined as repeated health-harming mistreatment of one or more persons. Now, according to that definition, studies show more than 1 in 4 workers in the United States have been bullied. And as many as 8 out of 10 workers have witnessed someone being bullied.
They also feel the old guilt thing. Like, I didn't say anything, you know, so does that make me a bad person? So they can go through a lot of trauma actually just witnessing it.
Now, the numbers are on such a rapid rise. Professors here at UNM are actually teaching students in their classes what to watch for with workplace bullying. Maybe even worse yet, they're teaching students how bad it can drastically affect the business. Things like poor production from stressed workers, people missing work, or maybe even worse yet, good employees leaving the job.
We have to show people, we have to educate them that there are lots of ways to interact in the workplace and that being disrespectful or harmful to others is just not the way it's going to be. And then we have to create a culture that says we're just not going to do that.
Experts compare workplace bullies to abusive spouses. In both cases, it rarely stops. And just like a child is told to tell on a bully, adults should realize they can be bullied too and not to hesitate to report it. Todd Kurtz, KOAT, Action 7 News.
European countries are developing laws against bullying. Experts say they treat it almost like how our country handles sexual harassment and discrimination.